Healthy food for kids. Have kids who are hooked on junk food? With these simple tips, you can get kids to eat right without turning mealtimes into a battle zone. How does healthy food benefit kids? Peer pressure and TV commercials for junk food can make getting your kids to eat well an uphill struggle. Factor in your own hectic schedule, and it's no wonder so many kids' diets are built around convenience and takeout food. But switching to a healthy diet can have a profound effect on children's health, helping to maintain a healthy weight, avoid certain health problems, stabilize their moods, and sharpen their minds. A healthy diet can also have a profound effect on a child's sense of mental and emotional well-being, helping to prevent conditions such as depression, anxiety, bipolar disorder, schizophrenia, and ADHD. Eating well can support a child's healthy growth and development into adulthood and may even play a role in lowering the risk of suicide in young people. If your child has already been diagnosed with a mental health problem, a healthy diet can help your child to manage the symptoms and regain control of their health. It's important to remember that your kids aren't born with a craving for French fries and pizza and an aversion to broccoli and carrots. This conditioning happens over time as kids are exposed to more and more unhealthy food choices. However, it is possible to reprogram your children's food cravings so that they crave healthier foods instead. The sooner you introduce wholesome, nutritious choices into your kids' diets, the easier they'll be able to develop a healthy relationship with food that can last them a lifetime. And it can be simpler and less time-consuming than you imagine. With these tips, you can instill healthy eating habits without turning mealtimes into a battle zone and give your kids the best opportunity to grow into healthy, confident adults. Encourage healthy eating habits. Whether they're toddlers or in their teens, children develop a natural preference for the foods they enjoy the most. To encourage healthy eating habits, the challenge is to make nutritious choices appealing. Focus on overall diet rather than specific foods. Kids should be eating more whole, minimally processed food, food that is as close to its natural form as possible, and less packaged and processed food. Be a role model. The childhood impulse to imitate is strong, so don't ask your child to eat vegetables while you gorge on potato chips. Disguise the taste of healthier foods. Add vegetables to a beef stew, for example, or mash carrots up with mashed potato, or add a sweet dip to slices of apple. Cook more meals at home. Restaurant and takeout meals have more added sugar and unhealthy fat, so cooking at home can have a huge impact on your kids' health. If you make large batches, cooking just a few times can be enough to feed your family for the whole week. Get kids involved in shopping for groceries and preparing meals. You can teach them about different foods and how to read food labels. Make healthy snacks available. Keep plenty of fruit, vegetables, and healthy beverages, water, milk, pure fruit juice, on hand so kids avoid unhealthy snacks like soda, chips, and cookies. Limit portion sizes. Don't insist your child cleans the plate, and never use food as a reward or bribe. Make mealtimes about more than just healthy food. Making time to sit down as a family to eat a home-cooked meal not only sets a great example for kids about the importance of healthy food, it can bring a family together. Even moody teenagers love to eat tasty, home-cooked meals. Regular family meals provide comfort. Knowing the whole family will sit down to eat dinner, or breakfast, together at approximately the same time every day can be very comforting for kids and enhance appetite. Family meals offer opportunity to catch up on your kids' daily lives. Gathering the family around a table for a meal is an ideal opportunity to talk and listen to your kids without the distraction of TV, phones, or computers. Social interaction is vital for your child. The simple act of talking to a parent over the dinner table about how they feel can play a big role in relieving stress and boosting your child's mood and self-esteem. And it gives you a chance to identify problems in your child's life and deal with them early. Mealtimes enable you to teach by example. Eating together lets your kids see you eating healthy food while keeping your portions in check and limiting junk food. Refrain from obsessive calorie counting or commenting on your own weight, though, so that your kids don't adopt negative associations with food. Mealtimes let you monitor your kids' eating habits. This can be important for older kids and teens who spend a lot of time eating at school or friends' houses. If your teen's choices are less than ideal, the best way to make changes is to emphasize short-term consequences of a poor diet, such as physical appearance or athletic ability. These are more important to teens than long-term health. For example, calcium will help you grow taller. Iron will help you do better on tests. Limit sugar and refined carbs in your child's diet. Simple or refined carbohydrates are sugars and refined grains that have been stripped of all bran, fiber, and nutrients, such as white bread, pizza dough, pasta, pastries, white flour, white rice, and many breakfast cereals. They cause dangerous spikes in blood sugar and fluctuations in mood and energy. Complex carbs, on the other hand, are usually high in nutrients and fiber and are digested slowly, providing longer-lasting energy. They include whole wheat or multigrain bread, high-fiber cereals, brown rice, beans, nuts, fruit, and non-starchy vegetables. A child's body gets all the sugar it needs from that naturally occurring in food. Added sugar just means a lot of empty calories that contribute to hyperactivity, mood disorders, and increase the risk for obesity, type 2 diabetes, and even suicidal behaviors in teenagers. How to cut down on sugar? The American Heart Association recommends that sugar intake for children is limited to 3 teaspoons, 12 grams, a day. A 12-ounce soda contains up to 10 teaspoons or 40 grams of added sugar, shakes and sweetened coffee drinks even more. Large amounts of added sugar can also be hidden in foods such as bread, canned soups and vegetables, frozen dinners, and fast food. In fact, about 75% of packaged food in the U.S. contains added sugar. Don't ban sweets entirely. Having a no-sweets rule is an invitation for cravings and overindulging when given the chance. Give recipes a makeover. Many recipes taste just as good with less sugar. Avoid sugary drinks. Instead, try adding a splash of fruit juice to sparkling water or blending whole milk with a banana or berries for a delicious smoothie. Create your own popsicles and frozen treats. Freeze 100% fruit juice in an ice cube tray with plastic spoons as popsicle handles. Or make frozen fruit kebabs using pineapple chunks, bananas, grapes, and berries. Find healthier junk food alternatives. Fast food is typically high in sugar, unhealthy fat, and calories and low in nutrients. Still, junk food is tempting for kids, so instead of eliminating it entirely, try to cut back on the times your kids eat fast food and, on the times that they do, make the healthiest choices possible.